Hi, welcome to the Burma Institute. Welcome to the live stream. Today we're going to make two things. I'm going to make a linear teardroppy bridal bouquet, and I'm going to make a table decoration. Today I'm using an oasis holder like this, a princess it's called, and I have taped that with some double-sided tape, and then around that I made some laner wool for the handle, like this, you see, there. And I also added, Jakester, I also added some ribbons. And it's actually quite a lot of ribbon that I used. We all sell this, by the way, of course, in our floral design shop. So I have added some broom. And I used some roses, and these roses I wired. And my name, by the way, is Jacqueline Burma. So, welcome to the live stream. I'm using some spray roses, two different kinds. I'm using Stamstetes, limonium, like this. I'm using Lysianthus or Eustoma. I'm using broom, Ginista. I'm using Hypericum. Hello, Jake. Welcome back. And I'm using some Bouvardia and some Achillea. Achillea filipendulina, or no, Achillea millefolia. And I'm using some hellebores. And I also use a lot of ribbons and stuff like that. So I'm going to make a little bit like a teardrop, like that. But I'm also actually making lines. And the table now is a little bit high for me, but let's see how we do. I'm using some spray roses to make it shorter, to go more to the height, to give it some more depth. And I hope my hand is holding it, because it's a little bit unstable. I'm making a line with the spray roses to the back. And also, by the way, I have sprayed the top of the oasis after it was wet with the Floralife aqua color. So it is not green anymore, it's pink. So it's easier to hide, to cover the oasis. I also used some broom to go to the front. And I will use some spray roses in between my shorter roses. It's not going to be a completely classic arrangement. It's also not going to be a completely modern arrangement or linear style. It's something in between. Lysianthus. Also a little bit to the back. Oops, broken. I'll place some Lysianthus in between the spray roses on the back. And I will use the smaller one to the outside and some bigger flowers to the depths. Ooh, let's take that out. Sorry for the noise. Like that. We'll do that later. So I can see also what I'm doing. Let's see, yeah, I broke this one. So I need to put that in again. I also have some very nice hellebores. And I'm working a little bit with the orange and the pink tones. And I'm using a lot of ribbon. Because I felt like that, I wanted to use that like that. So, a little bit more springy type, although I'm wearing my winter vest. But it has some spring colors, so let it be spring very soon, please. I have also some Tillandsia, which I'm going to use somewhere in the center, or a little bit off-center actually. To the back, so I give some more depth there, and some fluffiness. Oh, Angelica, you have a question or a remark.
Well, we have some people saying hello in the chat.
Oh, nice.
First of all, we have Frida saying goedemiddag allemaal.
Goedemiddag, Frida. Welcome to the show.
We have Lisa Florista saying hello, friends.
Hi, Lisa. How are you there?
We have Shaida saying goedemiddag allemaal.
Goedemiddag, Shaida. Welkom.
And we have Taiwan giving a 3 thumbs up.
Oh, nice. Thank you very much, Taiwan. Thank you for joining us again. I hope you will enjoy it.
And unfortunately, we have Angela saying apologies, but I won't be able to attend. I will watch on the edited version. Hope you all have a wonderful time and are duly inspired as always. Kisses.
Thank you very much, Angela. See you soon. So I also put some ribbons on the bottom, so they're hanging down, so it makes it a little bit more playful. I'm not using a lot of greens, and the greens that I am using are a little bit grayish. Mike, what was the name again of this? Remember? Well, next time.
You ask the person with the worst memory.
I will use that a little bit to the front. So it also gives some length to it. And I'm not anchoring this one, but I anchored the roses. So these roses are anchored at the back. So they won't fall out if the bride is in a hurry to go to church. Some very nice bouvardia, a little bit soft-toned bouvardia. And I spray painted it also the asparagus a little bit. So the asparagus is not with the gray spray, but it's pink spray that I used. Somewhere in between. So I'm hiding my flowers just a little bit. Not too much, but just a little bit. And let me see what I'm doing here. Yeah.
Is the name of the green maybe Phlebodium aureum?
That's probably the name, yes. Thank you. Who was that?
It was me.
Okay. Very good, Angelica. Very good. I'm also using some Tillandsium. Tillandsium. Now you get me upset. Tillandsia, sorry. Leftover from another demonstration, I think. And I'm also using some feathers, just because I can. Wait, what was that? So I should have connected that one. Like that. I thought I had another one. No? Well, maybe somewhere. And then I will also add some more broom to give it some more fluffiness and some more height.
So Funny Lee says, evening and greetings from Hong Kong.
Hi, Funny. Nice that you are joining. Thank you.
We have Ionella saying, hello, everyone.
Hi, Ionella.
And Lisa Florisa says, love the variety of textures. Beautiful color palette.
Oh, thank you very much, Lisa. I actually was inspired by my vest. You see here, pink and a little bit of orange. And I thought that would be a nice color to join in, to make in an arrangement. So, yeah, fun to do, right? Is it warm in here or is it just me?
I think it's your sweater.
Oh, probably. So I'm also all adding this to the princess, the Oasis Princess bridal holder. And using some status. So the colors are going towards each other. I'm not adding, I don't have to add so many flowers because I spray painted the Oasis holder, so it's not showing the real green color, which is very convenient at this moment. Just adding some ribbons and also to the other side. And I have this lovely ribbon a little bit more to the orange. Or the, yeah, kind of
coral.
Coral, thank you, yes. Yes. That's also my necklace. When we were, when Mike and I were in Italy for the, we visited the Europa Cup, I bought this necklace. So that was a couple of years ago. And still very useful and lovely to see. Little bit shorter, and this is rope with some wire inside. Axel also sells it, I think, in the floral design supplies. Still need to add a little bit more to get some more fluent lines. Yes, Angelica?
Yes, we have Gres Mozzi saying,
"Hi,
wintry greetings from Pennsylvania, USA."
Hi, nice that you are here. That's a long time ago that we've seen each other. Thank you for watching. Also some ribbon for the bride. Oh, and by the way, I'm making this bouquet because one of the students of the National Dutch Floral Design course, the professional one, they asked for a bridal bouquet. So that's why I'm making a bridal bouquet now. If you have any requests for arrangements that you like us to make during a live stream, please let us know in the comments and we'll see if we can honor your question. So please add your questions. Sorry? Was that, how long time ago was that? Do you remember when was the year? I think with, no, that it's really a long time ago. See, a lot of ribbon, drives you crazy probably, but I like it today, not always. Because normally I don't know what to do with ribbon, that's what I said last week, so I thought, okay, let's throw in some ribbon. And also because I have so much ribbon and also I have a little bit of gray, I also use a Vanda root to go in there. Let me see where I want it to go. Yeah, somewhere from there. So the gray is from the Tillandsia here into the Vanda root a little bit. And then I have one more. So we'll group the two together. Angelica?
Yes, we have Spencer Wagnon saying good morning from Texas and a question about the ribbon. How are you attaching the ribbons?
Oh, thank you for watching from Texas. Very nice that you join us today. I wired the ribbon on a 0.9 wire, and I use some of them single wires and some of them double wires, double leg. So in this case, I don't know if Mike can see that. Mm-hmm. It's like that.
You can see it too.
Okay, yes.
Nice.
Okay, so I think we have some more questions.
Well, Chris Motzi says, it's great to see you too, Jackie. You have a great memory to remember me from 2006.
Yeah, something like that. I knew it, I knew it. Thank you. Thank you, Chris. Thank you. So, yeah, that was the year when Neil Strain was there too, right? I think so. I think Neil was also in 2006. Let's add some more Bouvardia and then add a little bit more wildness on the head. So a little bit more broom, Ginesta. There to get more crazy. Yeah.
Grass says yes. Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, Neil Strain is originally from Ireland, and he has a very beautiful flower shop in London. He's a very good floral designer. He did, like Cressy, did the professional course, advanced course, and master course. And go and look when everybody is allowed to travel again. Go and look in London for Neil Strain. Floriculture, yes, I think so. But Neil Strain is very well known nowadays, so.
You can look on Google for his entrances. The flower entrance is beautiful.
Oh, yes, please have a look there, because the flower entrances at his flower shop is always great. Well, I thought I would do some sparkle in there too, because this feels like the 1920s a little bit. So I thought, oh yeah, I want some shimmer and shine. So let's do that. But I wired it also, I wired the ribbon. And I had a long side and a short side there. So that's going to be a little bit in front. And then this one goes under the Tillandsia. Then I need to cut it a little bit, because otherwise it's too long to go inside there. And then I wired it on another place. Yeah, thank you for showing up. And then let's move over some of these sparkly things. Like that. And this is for a bride who likes some shimmer and shine. Yeah. So, thank you. This is my first arrangement. I hope you can see it. So this is the side and the front. It could use some more Ginesta somewhere. I'll add it later, so when Mike takes photos of it, you will see them later on the photos. Let me get my other materials.
How do you call the other name for broom?
Ginesta.
Is that with a C? With
a G. I have some nice new containers. And these containers we also sell, but we don't ship because they're very fragile. Let's clean my desk a little bit. And I have them in different sizes and different heights. And this is a nice, you see there, beautiful one. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yes, so Chris Motzi says, such a fun bouquet. Love it. And the ribbons. They add a lot of the movement.
Oh, thank you very much. It's fun to do sometimes. So you have to be crazy a little bit. I have used some salix, some pussy willow. A very nice variety, which is a little bit pink. I have an Alstroemeria. And I hope I don't break the other glasses, but I also have an Alstroemeria for this one. Taken off the leaves, so it's a little bit less green, but more pink. And I use that opposite. This is for a table decoration. This can be anywhere loose on the table, so you still have some space for some nice dishes, of course. You need some food on the table too. Oh, this was broken. So when you and Amy, do you have any questions for me maybe? You're so quiet today.
Well, there was one question they asked about the name of the small white flower, and then between the haakjes, thingies? Bouvardia, but I think they meant the broom, because that's the small white flower. So then that's why I ask you the other name for the flower.
Okay. So I also have some beautiful freesias. The freesias, they remind me of my grandfather's flower shop. Because when I was young, my grandmother took me by the hand, lead me around the flower shop, let me smell the flowers with my hands behind my back, of course.
No
because
touching.
Otherwise I might have broken one. But anyway, and then I smelled the freesias and they really remind me still of the flower shop. Oh, the freesias were also for the bridal bouquet. I can still add them later. Because it's nice when the broom smells so nice, the freesias smell really gorgeous. So it is a very nice bouquet to keep close to your face. Beautiful, eh? I'm actually making the arrangement a little bit more not straight, also not really like a Dutch garden, but a little bit linear. And it's a diagonal linear. So, because I like that, because today we have the small containers with the angled leaves. Geweldig. With the angled feet, the legs. Some delphinium, and I need to sharpen my knife still. And those are beautiful, especially in this season, because they're not available, not in the garden right now in Holland, but they are at the greenhouses. And in the container, I am using the biodegradable oasis, so it's better for nature, although later on I will use some plastic on top of it. So, well, you have to separate like that. So I don't wire the gerberas, I just leave them on a natural stem. And because these gerberas have been in a bucket a little bit, they are a little bit at an angle. So they're not perfectly straight anymore. But who doesn't matter. I don't need them straight anyway. Some more roses. We also used them yesterday with the professional course. when we made the theater bridal bouquet. And we made that also on an Oasis holder. Also the princess. I like the princess a lot because the princess can be has a straight handle, so that means that you it's easy to cover the handle with some materials. The other ones, they have like this structure on top, but horizontal, and I really don't like that because it's difficult to cover, and I think it's also not doesn't feel right in your hand. It's too thick, and I don't like the wrinkles in it. They probably are not called wrinkles in English, but ribben, schubben, dingen. Oh, never mind. Yep. Another thing. I use the asparagus Meijeri, Asparagus densiflorus Meijers, or the Asparagus Meijeri. It can be used by two names, almost the same, but a little bit different. And I'm also using some very natural pussy willow. And guess what is spring without tulips in Holland, right? Well, yesterday I still had 50. Now I have about 8. They by accident used them. I didn't mention that on the list. That they had to use the orange tulips. So they used the pink tulips. But nevertheless, we have saved a few. So I can still show you some nice Dutch tulips. And the Keukenhof, by the way, is also opening this year. So if you can travel to Holland, visit the Keukenhof as well. And while you're at it, visit us. Yeah.
Yes, Ionella says, about roses, do you remove the thorns in all arrangements or just in hand tights? I usually keep them.
I remove the thorns, you said?
Do you remove the thorns?
I just remove the thorns whenever they are near my hand or when I have them under the rim of the vase. Then I remove them. Otherwise, I don't remove them. Because I like the way the natural look of the roses. So I also don't peel off the outer petals of the rose. I just keep them natural. And some still go up. Later on, these tulips will grow, so probably they will grow at an angle anyway. But I like to have them a little bit also vertical. Yes.
Yes, question from Taiwan.
Yeah.
What is the difference between table design and tablescape? It means to create landscape on the table?
Yeah. When you have a table design, it is several arrangements on the table. And if you make a tablescape, like a landscape, it's a whole thing. So the table is completely covered. I just cut off the stem of the ranunculus, but I need to make a hole because the stem of the ranunculus is hollow like the gerbera and like some other flowers. So I need to poke a hole first and then I will put the stem in. Otherwise the stem breaks very easy. Yeah, go ahead.
Lisa Florista says, this is so light and refreshing.
Oh, thank you very much, Lisa. Are you able to get flowers already? Or you still don't have any flowers because of Corona and the import of the materials? So some nice Lysianthus, Eustoma. I don't like the other word, Eustoma. Sounds really weird in Dutch. So, Lysianthus it is. Lovely Lissy. Sometimes they sell the short ones. So the open ones, they sell on a very short stem. And they are called lovely lissies. So that's the right word for that, I think. Because they're very lovely. Some of the light tops of the small tops of the Lysianthus are also very nice. And it also brings the color from the pink to the green of the asparagus and the green of the leaves of the Alstroemeria. Before I thought, when I got them yesterday, these pots, before I thought I would also spray paint these, because then it goes more to the pink. But I think that the color is also going towards the flowers a little bit. So they're not that off-white anymore. They're a little bit more going to the pink direction. So, some Achillea. Where did I put what? I put that in that little one. Oh, so this one can have some attention. Some love and attention. Here you go. Some color there. And then I'll use the side one that I took off. I will use that here short on the oasis. So if you are watching for the first time, my name is Jacqueline Boerma. I'm from the Boerma Institute. We have a flower design school in Holland, in Aalsmeer, in the heart of the flowers. And last year, 2020, we were supposed to celebrate our 40th anniversary, because my parents started this school in 1980. And I joined the school in 1981. So this year we also have a 40th anniversary again. So maybe celebrate that this summer. Can we?
It guys, would be nice.
Let's celebrate something. We need to have some more parties. Some nice ranunculus at the base. I don't put it too high, so you can still see the rim of the container, but also it hides a little bit. Ooh, did I break that? A little bit the oasis here on the side. What else do I have? I probably forgot something. Yes, I have some nice scabiosa. Also, again, to go a little bit more greenish. And these are so small, I can use them with a couple in a group. There. And I have some nice grass that will go on its own, because I only have one. I found that in the cooler, which I loved, so using that. Then, what do you think? Can it use some here? Yeah, sure. So a little bit deeper. And it also goes a little bit towards the brown of the oasis. So I don't have to cover all my oasis. I just need to cover a little bit. To go a little bit more to the coral, I will use some Bouvardia at the base. Yes, please.
Yes, question from Taiwan. Are the containers pottery or ceramic?
They are ceramic and they have wooden legs. Yeah, they're nice containers. Last year they had them also. They looked a little bit like concrete. And they were more straight, so they were gray. In this case, they have them in a little bit of bluish soft tone, like the 60s color, and then they have them in off-white and in ochre. So those were also very nice colors, but I wanted to match. Well, I had a pink idea, so I wanted to use some pink. I also had, there we go, some Brisa there. That's also nice to use. Oh, Gasmantium, sorry. Yep. The other one was this one was the Brisa. This one is the Gasmantium. Oh, yes. Hello, come back to me, please. So, like that, finish that. What else do I have? Well, maybe just a little bit. Oops, sorry. And then we need to poke something again. So probably the stem of the Lysianthus there. And then it turns a little bit more to the lilac color there. Some spray roses can be in there. Not too loud. This leaf can be taken off because it's above my other flower. And you see, I have two types of spray roses. So one turns in a little bit more to the coral and one stays pink. The more they open up, the more they go to more creamy color. So. We also have a lesson today. There is an international advanced course. But due to COVID, we only have one student, so he is having private lessons almost. Well, actually, he is having private lessons, which is very good for him, because he will open two flower shops in the Czech Republic in the autumn time. So. Some spray roses here. Can I do still something with this? Well, that would be nice. Still no questions, Angelica. Everything must be clear then. That's good. Then my explanation is not that bad. Some asparagus here to the side, so it also goes a little bit more to the horizontal part. And then we almost have weekend, guys. Last week we have started with the professional course. The professional course is the Dutch professional course is once a week, and we started with 14 students, which is a nice amount, but due to COVID, we cannot have more than 14 people in the classroom. But still, we were so lucky that we could start, because other schools are still closed. But because we have practical courses, the Dutch government allows us to continue with the lessons. Because some things cannot be learned on the online. Oh, yes. The situation, yes. Here you go. Yeah, Angelica.
Yes, question from Chris Motzi.
Yeah.
Do you do anything special to condition your hellebore?
Yes, I water it. No, I don't. No, it's fresh from the auction, so fresh from the grower. So I don't really need to condition it.
But if you would condition it, what would you use?
I would some kind of Floralife or Grisal to keep it longer. If I would need to, but I have to. Probably it's the. The normal Grisal or Floralife that you can use. There's no special need for that. It's not like you have lilacs or woody stems like that. So then you need to have a special Grisal or Floralife. Yes. And of course we sell Floralife on our webshop. Yes.
Yes, question from Taiwan. Jacqueline, you have this idea of design after you find these containers?
Last year I did also a design with this and a little bit more simple, a little bit more
small scale.
Small scale, yeah, not exactly like minimalistic, that's the word. And now because of course it's a demonstration, I like to use some more flowers because you come and look for the floral design. So that's why I used quite a lot of flowers in this arrangement. Ik ging wat pakken. Ik weet het weer, het staat aan de andere kant. It's this one, but then the other one. I put it somewhere, yes, here. Yeah, oh yes, and because it's spring, I can also use some butterflies. Maybe I hope they come out again. Like that. I use some pebbles, some small ones, to cover a little bit of the oasis. That one is done. That one is also done. I don't want to do too much because otherwise it gets too busy. And my bridal bouquet was already busy, so I think we should keep this a little bit more simple. Then I can pour this in just on top of the base there. Let it go in. And these are kind of jumpy, so if you hear something ticking, that's probably that it falls on the floor there, jumps away. So I have some pink also at the base. The pink and the brown, they can connect inside there. Then I also, when you make a design on these legs, make sure that you be very careful with the pots, because when you push, they might fall over, they might tip. So be very careful with that. Let's see if I can pour this in. Yeah. Well, these are not the water pearls. So these will not swell up and they will not get bigger. So that's a good thing. Otherwise, they would jump out of the containers this night. One time we used water pearls, and then there was a student. She heard she heard something at night, like puk, 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 puk. And then the water pearls they got more water, and they jumped out of the vase from her arrangement. We made a cascade arrangement, and then the water pearls were not fully swollen up, so they were jumping out of her container, and that's a real strange thing. When you wake up at night and you hear something. Oh yeah, there they go. Yeah.
Lisa Florista says, this is so lovely.
Thank you very much, Lisa. So in between my tulips, let's see, yep. There you go. Do I have them all? I think so. Maybe later. I need some more. So So I'll put it there. Then I also have some other stuff. Stuff, Mike. So. So I have this nice tablecloth, which is a little bit more coral, which that's the color I really like at this moment. And it's also like velvety. And it's from Halbach. We have a lot of ribbon and materials from Halbach. We sell that also on our webshop. Let's go there.
Oh, that looks really, really nice. Really
yeah,
soft.
Yeah, it's a nice. So you wanna. Let's see, how long is it? Yeah, somewhere there. And then, of course, hoe heet dat ook weer? Pailletten in het Engels.
Sequins.
Sequins, ja. Yeah. Shimmer and shine. So, party. I love this. Kun jij er even aan trekken dat hier ooit een beetje recht hangt zo? That would be nice, thank you. Let me see what else. I can use some feathers and some apples to get some more shine into it. There you go. And then just place the arrangements randomly over the table. There. Go behind. Oh yeah, and then these are also so lovely. The pussy willow. So like that. Yeah, you have questions?
Well, Chris Motzi says, lovely, enjoy your presentation very much. Thank you for offering the live stream session to keep us inspired. This is my first, hope to enjoy many more.
Thank you very much. That's very lovely to hear. That's why we do it. We like to entertain you. And if you have any questions or you have anything that you want to know, just let us know in the comments. And we'll be back in 14 days with another live stream. Connie, yes, Connie van der Westerlaken. She's also one of our former students. She will give a live stream with a special event, some very special things. Angelica?
Yes, Spencer Wagman says, so pretty.
Oh, thank you very much. So, I thank you a lot. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you next time too. Come in, join us. Hit the like and subscribe button, please, please. So, thank you. Bye-bye.
Yeah, we all go.
Say goodbye. So, bye-bye. Nee, kom maar. Zeg maar, maar. Kom. Oh. Bye bye.
So, this is a new introduction. This is our new intern, Selina. And our assistant branch manager, Jake and Axel.